How to create realistic falling snow effect in Photoshop. Welcome back to PhotoshopDESIRE.com YouTube channel. In this Photoshop effects tutorial, we'll learn how to create snowflake brush and how to use. Using Photoshop, making a custom brush that will randomize snowflakes in different manners, such as shape, size, opacity, angle and placement can take a winter themed image to the next level. Before starting, it is extremely important to pick a photo that will seamlessly and most obviously fit with a winter theme. I am using Photoshop CC 2017. However, this should work in most versions of Photoshop. Let's start creating custom brush for snow. Add a new blank layer. Select brush tool and choose a brush from the panel. Click on brushes panel toggle icon in the options bar at the top of the screen. By default, the brushes panel opens to the brush presets options. Select brush tip shape. Size slider is the general actual size of the brush. Starting off at 100 pixels, but depending on the resolution of the image, the size of the brush will have to be adjusted. The lower the resolution, the smaller the brush, and a larger brush should be used for larger images. The roundness setting will affect the shape of the snowflakes. To look most natural, the flake should be more oval than circular. I find that setting the roundness to somewhere between 50% to 70% works. In general, setting the hardness to 15% when placing snow around the subject works great. However, when placing flakes on the subject, such as on the hair, the hardness should be harsher, around 75%. Spacing setting will control how close and how packed the snowflakes will be in relation to each other. Spacing the flakes at 400% gives it a natural look. Now go to Shape Dynamics option. Snowflakes in reality are unique, and image should reflect that. Size jitter setting when set to 100% will randomize the size of the flakes. Keep minimum diameter 25%. Snow doesn't fall from the sky in a straight line, each flake flutters and makes its way down, taking a unique path. The angle jitter setting will randomize the angle of your brush, mirroring the path snowflakes take on their way down. Keep roundness jitter 100%. And minimum roundness at 25%. Move on to scattering option. Make sure to check both axes box. The scatter setting will scatter the cluster of flakes, so they don't appear to be falling in a straight line. Usually, 1000% does the job, however, if you find that the clusters are too scattered, bringing down this setting can prove to be helpful. According to the number set on count control, the amount of flakes that appear per click and drag will vary. Leaving it the lower number will give you better control of snowflake placement. On average, setting the count anywhere from 1 to 8 is great. Keep count jitter 100%. Go to transfer option. The opacity of each flake must be unique, so that the image will look more realistic. These settings will randomize the opacity. Both opacity and flow jitter should be set to 100%. Make sure that all controls are set to off. Smoothing helps reduce sharp angles as you drag your mouse or stylus. Now start painting with custom brush on the image. To save you the time, save the custom brush and name it. If it were really snowing, the person would have some collection of snowflakes in hair. Let's add another blank layer to add snow on her hair and dress. When considering the placement of snow in a person's hair, turn down all settings a few notches so the flakes are not as random. The actual placement needs to be extremely controlled, because the flakes must be positioned in spots where snowflakes would actually rest. Add another blank layer, but this time we add medium-sized snowflakes. The upside of creating a custom brush is that the brush lends itself to fine-tuning according to your exact needs. Each setting will affect the brush in different ways. Simply paint on gaps to fill with extra snowflakes which has different sizes and shapes. If you want lighter snow, then hide the snow on background layer, which contains snowflakes that gives effect which are nearer to camera. Finally, add crisp winter color lookup to photo. Change blending to color. And we are done. Here is before and after results. To save you the time, I uploaded 3 custom snow brushes from this tutorial to my official website. You can download it for free. I hope that you enjoyed this tutorial. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe to our channel for more interesting tutorials. Post a comment, click thumbs up, like and share to get more videos. See you again in next video tutorial.